Good morning. It's 7:04. I'm Willa Sandmeyer with KCLU News. Santa Ana winds kicked up as predicted yesterday, but firefighters were able to limit the growth of the Woolsey brush fire. The 85,000-acre blaze in Ventura and Los Angeles counties is now 50% contained. Air tankers and helicopters were used during the day to try to stem flare-ups of the fire. That effort focused in the Santa Monica Mountains. More than 170 structures have been destroyed. A section of Highway 101 in Agoura Hills, which had been closed for several days because of the fire, reopened last night. The weather forecast calls for strong Santa Ana wind conditions to continue in Ventura and LA counties through 5 o'clock tomorrow evening. Firefighters say despite the progress that's been made, a number of evacuation orders do remain in effect this morning. LA County Fire Chief Daryl Osby says the ongoing Santa Ana wind threat means major flare-ups are still possible.
We're still being hampered by people that have not evacuated. I know that's been mentioned over and over and over again in relation to evacuations and animals, and when we have to confront those types of situations within the fire scene, it takes away from our firefighters' ability to protect your structures and help with containment.
The chief says people who ignore evacuation orders and then try to leave when their homes are threatened make it difficult for fire crews trying to move in to save property. Hundreds of people in Ventura and Los Angeles counties have lost their homes due to the ferocious Woolsey fire. KCLU's Deborah Green speaks to one of the victims.
There's nothing there.
As Westlake Village resident Karen Anzalone reflects on the loss of her home. She lived with her son and mother in a mobile home park on Sherwood Drive. But the Woolsey fire has reduced her street to rubble.
You just never think it's going to happen to you.
She says she'll miss some of her sentimental items.
The hard thing is I have antiques that I've had for like 40 years. So they're all gone.
Anzalone was out of town when the area was evacuated and told her son not to take anything.
I was more concerned about him getting my mom out of there and, you know, safety of people is first, and your jewelry and clothes and things don't matter as much.
She says the most important thing is that she and her family are alive.
You have to put one foot in front of the other and, you know, mourn the loss and move forward. It's just things. That's what you have to remind yourself.
Deborah Green, KCLU News.
Plans for a memorial service have been announced for the Ventura County Sheriff's Sergeant who died trying to stop a gunman who went on a rampage at a Thousand Oaks Club last week. Sergeant Ron Helis will be honored at a public service this Thursday at Calvary Community Church in Westlake Village. The service will be held at noon. It is open to the public, but people are advised to come early because of an anticipated large turnout. Sergeant Helis died Wednesday night when he tried to stop a gunman at the Borderline Bar and Grill in Thousand Oaks. He was one of